Welcome to the second Google Sketchup object importing tutorial. In this tutorial, we will be covering adding basic collision to your models. As you can see, I'm using the same Mustang as the first tutorial, and the first thing that I'd like to draw your attention to are the standard camera views. If you click on camera and then go to standard views, clicking on one of these options will snap the camera to one of the faces of the model. So first, select the top view, and then use the rectangle tool to draw a rectangle that's roughly the same size as the Mustang. Okay. Then use the push-pull tool to pull the rectangle up until it's level with the roof. This tool is often called an extrude tool in other applications. Now orbit around the model and use the push-pull tool to make the cuboid roughly the same size as the vehicle. It doesn't matter if some of the model is showing through the collision volume, but you want to make it as close a match as possible. Making collision volumes that are a better fit will be covered in a later tutorial. The standard cameras are handy for this section of the volume creation. You can use them to snap to whichever face it is you want to edit. Now if you use the push-pull tool on faces that are larger than the screen, it can become very difficult to use. If you zoom out a bit and change the camera angle, it becomes much, much easier. As you can see here, it should be a lot easier now. Yeah, that's a lot better. So there we have it, one cuboid that's roughly the same shape as the vehicle. Okay, what you need to do now is use the select tool and triple click on one of the faces. This will select the collision volume but not the vehicle, and then go to plugins, export an ASE format. This time change export selected to yes. This will export the volume but not the car, and again call it whatever you want, but remember to use the .ASE file extension. So Mustang collision .ASE. As you can see, it saved much quicker than the last tutorial. That's because it's a very simple volume. So go to the folder where you saved the volume and right click on it, and then click on open with. So right click and open with. At this point you need to select a text editor such as Notepad or WordPad, and make sure that the always use the selected program to open this type of file option is ticked. And once you click OK, the collision volume will be opened in a text format, and the important parts are the lines node name PQ shape 1. So that one there, and the one two lines below it. So what you need to do now is add the letters UCX and an underscore before the P. That's U for Unreal, C for Charlie, and X for X-ray. So that's UCX underscore P cube shape 1. And do the same for the second line. Once you've done that, you need to select everything from the start geom object to the bottom of the file. So select them and copy. You can use edit then copy or the Control plus C shortcut. So now you go into the model file that you made in the last tutorial, Mustang 3, and simply go to the end of the file and paste the collision text and save it. So scroll to the bottom and paste the collision volume in. And it's best if you give it a different name so the original model's still intact, in case you make a mistake with the collision. so Mustang4.ase, and make sure that the file type is set to all files or it won't save properly. Now you go into MovieZoo and import it in the same way as the previous tutorial. Use ID textures, double-sided facing, but if you wish to save the set, change map alpha from none to opacity mask. And I'm just going to fast forward this part. The importing and color changes are exactly the same as the previous tutorial. Okay, the colors are all in the same place as you can see. So as you can see, this one's already sitting properly on the ground, and I'll just use this hexagonal prism to demonstrate the rest of the collision volume. So it sits correctly on the top, whereas in the original it doesn't, and on the original it goes right through it. So I'll just lift this up and turn it around and show you what happens if you place it on its side. See, it sinks in at the front. And it really sinks in on its side. Whereas with this one, helps for turn off, keep upright first. With this one, you can turn it on its side and it's fine. And you can put it on its roof and it's also fine. So, there we have it. One Mustang with simple collision.